Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. You can see I'm out of my kitchen right now. That's because we're getting ready to go on a field trip. And where we're going is Boone Tavern. And you've heard me mention that before because it's in the little town of Berea, Kentucky, which is about 12 miles south of here. And that's where we went for the spoonbread festival. When you go into the shops, there's always pottery, jewelry, lots of handcrafted items, and it's a really interesting place to visit. We're in Warren May's shop in Berea, and he specializes in woodworking, and in particular, he's known for the dulcimers that he makes. And you might be able to see some around the wall and here at the front window.
Here we are in downtown Berea. I've been making dulcimers 37 years. It's the easiest instrument to play. Play numbers 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we have the same numbers here in Kentucky. We just get them mixed up every now and then. But that, sometimes that happens. But I wonder how the old folks are at home. And I wonder if they'll miss me when I'm gone. I wonder if they pray for the boy's gone away. Dad left his dear old parents all alone. Just a village and a homestead on the farm. And a mother's love to shield us from all harm. A sweetheart brave and true. A place of love so dear. Just a village and a homestead on the farm. Sweetheart, brave and true, the place he loves so dear, just a village and a homestead on the farm. Make 'em for fun.
We've just stepped inside the lobby of the Boone Tavern Hotel and Restaurant, and there's a little niche here where there is a picture gallery, and it shows some of the famous people who have been here. Governor and Mrs. Lawrence Weatherby, President and Mrs. Calvin Coolidge, Eleanor Roosevelt, Archbishop Desmond Tutu, Robert Frost, Richard Hougen, who did the recipe books from which the recipes are based, Nellie Frost, Wallace Nutting, Maya Angelou, Dalai Lama, Alex Haley, Henry Ford, Duncan Hines, and Thornton Wilder. This is the actual lobby of the Boone Tavern Hotel, and we're getting ready to go into the dining room, so I wanted to show you what it looks like here in the lobby. So it's just some nice sofas and chairs. This is another view of the lobby area. There's a nice comfortable sitting area right here. Getting ready to sign in to eat, and I just want to point out that cookbook, Look No Further, was the first Richard Hougen cookbook for Boone Tavern. Seated and brought some water and some little balls here of butter. And I'm going to tell you a few things that are on the appetizer menu. Soup, salads, and starters. They have smoked catfish and crawfish cake, sweet potato grit. Entrees, they have chicken flakes in a bird's nest. We've had that before, it's really good. Pork chops, the tricky way, we've had that also. Pan-seared scallops, bluegrass lamb pot pie, brown sugar salmon, grilled ribeye, New York strip, oat-crusted rainbow trout, and roasted duck leg. A waitress just brought the appetizer of the day, and it is a black-eyed pea relish. So it looks pretty good.
The restaurant is compared to what we've had previously when we've come here.
It's got a new fresh base. It's a donut. I think I like the charm of the old place in a way a little bit better, but this is a more upscale.
I ordered an iced tea without any lemon. That's why I like to drink it. And also I'm starting out with a garden salad. See, they pose it so it has two little cherry tomato halves. And I chose blue cheese dressing. Yes, thank you.
That's a good rip.
I didn't.
You did.
Doesn't like spoonbread.
You don't like it?
No, I do like it. Oh. I did not meet anyone who doesn't.
Oh, right.
If you
I'm
like.
Still eating on my spoonbread, and they just brought me my entree. And this is chicken in a bird's nest. Actually, what it is these are white meat chicken with gravy, and these are sort of french fried potatoes making a nest, and there's mashed potatoes and green beans. Rick's gonna tell you what he's got, just a second.
This is another signature dish of Boone Tavern. We call it pork chops in some tricky way. The tricky way is to use tomato paste and Parmesan cheese. It's served with, I guess these are greens, some bean sprouts, and some...
And I will be making one of these two dishes. I haven't decided which one, but I have the recipe book. And it's either going to be chicken in a bird's nest, or it's going to be pork chop some tricky way. So I'll have that uploaded in the next few days. Don't count on it tomorrow, but pretty soon you'll be seeing one of these two dishes. Made by Betty.
It's a custard, it has custard consistency and a caramel topping. Then we have a Boone Tavern traditional dessert. It is a chocolate spoonbread. I would compare it to a chocolate cake or a brownie. We have a cinnamon apple crisp, which is very good heated up with ice cream on top. We have another Boone Tavern traditional dessert, which is a banana bread pudding. Here we have a race day pie, which is very similar to a derby pie. It's a pecan pie with chocolates. And we have in the front center, this is actually specifically for the season, is a pumpkin, well, a spiced pumpkin cheesecake with cinnamon.
They all look good. I think I'll take the derby like pie.
Yes, ma'am. And may I get
you? I'm going to try this game, which is called Skittles. And you have this pin that you're going to pull a string that you have wrapped around it and let it go and see what you can knock down, and they have different point values. So here goes. Okay, I made a big score of 10.
Rick's gonna try it this time. Let's see how well he does. Ooh, 50 points there. Oh, he's all done. So he's got 50 and 5 and 5
and 5.
And 5. So we have 65 points for Rick. Good job.
We're back from our field trip to Boone Tavern, and we had a great time, great dinner. I would like to say just a little bit about that restaurant. It is owned and operated by Berea College. And I want to say that the college actually was intended for impoverished Appalachian children, or young women and men. And there was no tuition, and there still is no tuition. Nowadays there are about 1,500 students at the college and no tuition. They do have to pay, I think, something for their room and board, but they have a work-study program, and they get paid a certain amount, and they have to work maybe from 10 to 20 hours a week, depending on the agreement that they have. So it is a wonderful way for some students who would not be able to go to college for them to get an education. And I will have to say, my three brothers, who are all older than I am, went to Berea College and all graduated and all came out very well. So it's a wonderful place to go and visit. And if you ever are in Kentucky and want an interesting place to just hang out for a while or to have dinner or lunch or breakfast, try Boone Tavern.